and also current situation of COVID and also the vaccination coverage. You tell us who all will be present and the new variant, which WHO says is a variant of concern, likely to be the focus too?
Absolutely, Abhishek. The two important components that are likely to dominate the meeting that Prime Minister Narendra Modi is chairing today in the morning at 10:30 a.m. Number one, the COVID situation, not only in India, but what are the global parameters, what exactly the situation globally and how it can impact us. That's number one. Number two, the vaccination coverage or the vaccination status in country. What more can be done to increase this vaccination drive or the vaccination coverage? So that's the number two point that is likely to dominate in this meeting in 10:30 at 10:30 a.m. Now, various stakeholders from Ministry of Health and Family Welfare and various secretaries, primarily of various ministries. That are likely to chair this important meeting. And importantly, we know this fact that as far as the COVID-19 situation is concerned, domestically in India primarily, the number of cases have reduced drastically. Now, when Delta variant did hit our country in the month of March, April, at that point in time, we were getting 4 lakh cases on a daily basis. And now, primarily, we are witnessing that the number of daily cases is close to 8,000 to 9,000. Today, we have received close to 8,000 daily new cases primarily. So the number of virus cases in India is, comparatively very low as of now. It is because of the high vaccination coverage and various measures taken by the government. And on the other side, the main point of discussion is, of course, likely to be the new variant that has emerged. And even the World Health Organization has termed it as the variant of concern, the Omicron virus primarily, that is the mutation that we have seen in Africa and, of course, specifically in Botswana. And, of course, one of the cases has also been found in Belgium as well. So it has reached Europe as well. And the experts, as of now, the experts are saying that this variant of concern, the Omicron primarily, spreads much more faster, is comparatively much more easily spreadable as compared to the Delta variant. So in that context, this meeting is going to be very much significant as to what is the preparedness of India as far as combating the new virus if it hits the country like India. And of course, what are the healthcare infrastructure that are in place? What more needs to be done specifically in tier 2 town, tier 3 town, village level, block level? What are the healthcare preparedness? What healthcare infrastructure is present there? We also know that to fight against COVID-19, oxygen plays a significant role. And we have seen that how various oxygen plants have been, installed in various parts of country. And now in every district primarily, the focus has been that at least one mega oxygen plant can be there so that it can, it can create the oxygen supplies mechanism. So in that context, what is the status so far as oxygen plants are concerned? Because under the PM CARES Fund, it was decided that at least every district primarily in our country will be having the oxygen plant. Even the private hospitals have come forward and they have installed their own capacities as far as oxygen plants are concerned. So yes, the private hospitals have come forward. States are ensuring that in each and every district primarily, at least one oxygen plant can be there. So in that context, this meeting is going to be very much important as to what are the healthcare preparedness required and what infrastructure related to healthcare we have already installed. And if in case this new virus hits, that means Omicron, if it hits country like India, what preparedness or what precautions or what measures are likely to be taken up,
sure,
by the government. So in that context, this meeting is going to be very much significant.
Right, and also, Arun, the meeting comes as the cumulative number of doses under the country's vaccination drive has crossed 1.2 billion doses. And also, this would be the second meeting in the month. The first was held on November 3rd, chaired by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. He met with the officials and also the districts where the vaccination coverage was low, and the respective chief ministers also. You think these issues might also be addressed where the vaccination coverage is low?
Absolutely. We are inching towards 125 crore vaccination, the doses that are being administered. So yes, there are also states like Himachal Pradesh, but Goa, Uttarakhand for that matter, some of the northeastern states, Daman and Diu, Dadra and Nagar Haveli. Over here, we have seen almost 100% vaccination and even as far as first dose is concerned. And when we talk about the second dosage, more than 50 to 60%, people have been vaccinated as far as second dose is concerned in these states. And the various states like Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh for that matter, over there the vaccination coverage drive is very much high. But there are few districts primarily, I mean, if you look at all across the country, the vaccination coverage is increasing massively, and we are witnessing a very high vaccination coverage, even in the far-flung areas. And of course, in the tough terrains, vaccine delivery via drones is being done. So we are witnessing it all across the country. The vaccine is being ensured that it reaches to the people of our country. But there are few districts in our country whereby low vaccination coverage is a cause of concern. So in that context, how vaccination coverage can be increased, that's number one. Now we have, vaccines like Covishield, Covaxin, we have Sputnik in place, and of course Zydus's Zycov-D will of course soon be in place. There are also recently talks that the teenagers primarily, that means the age group from 12 to 18, when can they get the vaccines primarily? So in that context, of course, there are various researches happening, there are various discussions happening in various ministries. All the stakeholders are also discussing that when that can be made possible, how can regular infra can be created for that, so that the age group of 12 and 18, they can be vaccinated. Because we know this fact that in various other countries, in some of the developed countries, we have witnessed that the children's or the teenagers, they are being vaccinated now. So will India take that leapfrog or will go in that direction that now infra can be created? Because we have already achieved a big milestone of close to 125 crore vaccines that's being administered. So will the children be brought into the category? And of course, what more needs to be done so that the vaccination coverage can increase in the districts primarily, whereby there were low vaccine coverage? So this meeting will of course be focusing on these aspects as well. So yes, indeed, a significant meeting that Prime Minister Narendra Modi is going to chair today in the morning.
Absolutely, and the government has allowed the resumption of vaccine exports also, and we are in surplus of the vaccines, and the active cases have been declining too, but again,